Only Human Radio.
Well, it's only turned out to be Series 2, Episode 8, isn't it? Series 2, Episode 8. And do you know what's happened?
What's happened?
I'll tell you what's happened. We've got no Gary Newman anymore. He's binned us off. Oh. Stopped answering the phone.
No way.
Yeah, way. Andy has left the scene. He's not with us.
No way.
He's not
That's
here.
Sad.
We've got no Andy. We've got no Gary. So it's just... It's us three, the three stooges. It's me, Phil, and Martin.
Three amigos.
Exactly.
Yes.
It's going to be special.
Yeah, we might make one Andy Brain between us.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I'm kind of hoping. There'll be a combo in there. I've got a cup of tea, which is most unusual. You guys have actually got beers.
I've got a beer.
Highly jealous of. So, you know, we're just going to have to make the most of a bad lot, really, and do the best we possibly can, fudge together what we can. But I tell you what, we fudged together some music tonight. It's a fudge-tastic treat. I love a slice of fudge at Christmas.
I do. It's delicious. With a mistletoe on the top, which is poisonous, by the way, kids, don't eat it.
Exactly, absolutely. Don't touch that fruit, that forbidden fruit. So we probably really ought to start talking about the show, really. We've got an amazing lineup tonight. You'll also see it depends, you won't see it if you listen on the radio. If you're watching on the thingy, you'll hopefully see that we're actually in person here as well, and you're actually seeing us. So we have got an amazing array of music that we've got lined up tonight. So coming up first, what have we got? We've got something super duper special, I think, coming up first, haven't we? Martin, you've been in charge of lineup. What have we got?
Well, first up, we've got New Arcades, as the name of the group, and it's called Afterlife.
Okay.
Now,
Afterlife or Afterlight?
That's a good point, actually. I think it's Afterlight. I wrote down. Yeah, I think it's the same mistake the other DJ made, actually. Afterlight, I think it is, yeah. This track actually followed on from one of my tracks a few weeks ago on BBC Introducing, Wales.
That was nicely dropped in there, Martin.
Oh, absolutely. And I was really impressed. I contacted the guys. They're a duo. I thought they were from Cardiff, but it also says they're from London. So maybe it's a bit of a Cardiff-London between... So there's obviously a Welsh connection for some reason, and because they obviously got played on BBC Introducing Wales. So this is heavily retro wave synth pop type of song.
I had real summer vibes for me. It's a summer's evening, and I got some real warm summer vibes out of this. Phil's put his T-shirt on, so he must have felt some summer vibes there too.
Yeah, I did. I felt I could hear those Simmons type drums from the '80s in there. I could see the hexagon pads being beaten away.
That's right.
And it's got a DX7 type bass. It was got a real big sort of 80s vibe. And I've been on their website. There's a guy's called Dean Carty and Adam Sullivan. And they described themselves as a nostalgic 80s inspired sound. And I think they're spot on there.
I thought it sounded very much like Axel F, from Beverly Hills.
Yes.
And the bass line was very Ultravox to me, that sort of thing.
Absolutely. I mean, with this thing, we've got some very slick music on tonight, actually, some amazing production. And this is a good way to start it all, because the production on this is pretty awesome, actually. So I tell you what, why don't we... I can't even pretend to do things like stick the cassette in the hole, because if we're doing it on video, people can see we're not doing it now. So, Martin, you're just going to have to pretend to put your hand underneath the desk and stick a cassette in the hole. So put your cassette in the hole. Not with your hands in front of the camera. That's just ruined the whole thing. Oh, Martin. You've let yourself down and you've let everybody else down at the same time. Well, I think we'll just leave that there. This is New Arcades After Light.
Medication 1, 2, 3.
Only Human Radio.
Wow, that was New Arcade's Afterlight. Martin's just clapping in the background out of excitement there because he was just enjoying that so much. And it did have that summer's evening vibe. Now, calm down, Martin.
Sorry.
Are you calm enough now to be able to talk?
I am.
Right. Okay. that was a great piece of music. It was lovely. And just out of interest then, how did you manage to get onto the BBC show to notice that this song was on there after you?
You basically go onto the BBC website and you upload any of the tracks and you hope. I've been lucky to have been played when I lived in Devon, BBC Devon twice. Never on BBC Wales. So it was a first. It was actually like an introducing show. It was a particular DJ. I've forgotten his name now. You just get an email on the day and you panic.
Yeah, I've been played on it once. And the same happened to me. On the day, they emailed and said, I've been picked to go on, yeah.
You've had some stuff on other places in the past, though, Phil, haven't you?
Yeah, but that was different. This was just me on my own.
Ah, right.
You mean when I was signed? Yeah.
Yeah. No, I was just going to drop that in there. Yeah. When you were signed.
That wasn't just me. So that was the talents of many other people. But once I did get on BBC introducing, but you have to register, don't you, Martin, first? Register on the BBC thing first.
To your account.
Account. That's it. So although we've both been played, it is, you have to be quite decent track to get on it.
Yeah, I know, because I did submit a song and I didn't hear anything back.
No, that's what happens most of the time.
It really is luck of the draw sometimes.
Not sure it's luck of the draw. I think it's more to do with quality and talent. But anyway, yeah, let's move on very quickly from that. We'll try and stick a link in somewhere for anybody who wants to go and submit a song into there. But it's a lot easier to get your song on here. Let's just put it that way. But that doesn't mean the quality is any lower. I'm not trying to say that, because the quality is extremely high. Speaking of which, Phil, what we got coming up next?
Ross Alexander, isn't it?
I think it is.
Drifter. Song about chocolate bar, which we all love. You know, we love a bit of a chocolate bar on this show. But there's nothing creamy about this track. It's a real good club thumper, isn't it, Martin?
It is. I love the sequences on this. I assume is it all hardware based that Ross performs?
Yeah, I think he's got an Akai MPC X he uses. I'm not sure what other bits he uses, but I think that's the heart of everything. And it is a monster of a thing. It's an amazing piece of machine.
It's got a real sort of old house vibe to it, I think.
Yeah.
A lot of his stuff does, Phil, doesn't it?
Yeah, with like a bit, it's got some modern touches in there as well. It's got some real nice little sprinkles of lifters and what have you that come in and out. And really well structured dance track. I can imagine, you know, building up a sweat to it. Definitely.
I'm not sure when I was younger. I see. Oh, right. I've got completely the wrong end of the stick there for a minute, Phil. Oh, and a touch queasy.
Well, if you want to build up that sort of steam heat type of sweat, yeah, why not?
Well, I tell you what, Martin, why don't you get your cassette in your hand? Let's see if we can do. Let's see if we can do a good job of it this time. So pop your cassette in. This is Ross Alexander Drifter. Look at that. That just looks wrong, Martin. Hopefully this... Anyway, this is Ross Alexander Drifter. Thank you. Wow, that was Ross Alexander Drifter. He does know how to put a dance track together, doesn't he? I mean, he really does know how to structure something and get your heart pumping and your hand thumping in the air.
Yeah, it was great.
Superb.
It was great with me, Bluetooth speakers on, bopping around the bedroom. Superb.
It was a lovely sight for all of us, Phil.
You've really got to turn that Zoom camera off when you're doing that, Phil.
I just like that you got that GoPro on your head so we can see exactly your world as you're doing it as well. It was very impressive.
Yeah. It's like my stomach was being viewed through a security mirror. Terrible. Never usually looks like that. Anyway, carry on. Flat as a pancake. 47. Not six pack, party seven.
Rodney's party seven.
What's next then?
What's next? I'll tell you what's next. And this is a bit of an unusual one, really. It's Tors.
Yeah, who's going to say this? Because, it's Omnan Nauka.
That's exactly the way I was going to pronounce it. Omnan Nauka.
Omnan Nauka.
Omnan Nauka.
Torsk's normally a little bit more. Bit, what's the word? Raw is probably a good word for it. A little bit harder, but this was a much softer tune, I thought, from the usual stuff.
It's a real ambient sort of groove to it, and there's sax in there, but I'm not sure. It sounds like it.
Yeah, it is. It's his mate, Gary Foote. Yeah, Foote playing the sax.
Nice improv then. Yeah, nice improv.
Yeah. Actually playing a real sax, not a synthesised. Yeah. Actual instruments being played.
And another interesting fact about Torsk. Torsk is a codfish.
Now that is an interesting fact. Is it a type of codfish?
That's what he's named. It's a Norwegian or something Scandinavian. Cue your impression. Scandinavian word for a codfish.
Scandinavian fish and chips. Playing it on a shitty pin.
Why is it so funny? I don't.
It's because it's not.
Carry on.
Well, I tell you what. Marcy, have you got your cassette ready?
Yeah, got it.
Excellent stuff. Right, well, let's pop the cassette in. This is Torsk Omnan Nauka. You didn't even do the move, Martin.
Got stuck again.
Only human, human radio. Radio.
Wow, that was Torsk Omnanalka. And it's much more laid back and more ambient than the usual sort of stuff that you get from Torsk, isn't it?
Yeah, just a touch of jazz feel to it as well, with the sax and that, the impro.
Liked it. It's a very different direction. Yeah, different direction, but still, you know, thoroughly enjoyable, as all Torsk stuff is. Right, now, this next one is something a little bit, special is the only way I can describe this. I wrote down Holy Mother of God as my first line for this. It's
a bit of a Line of Duty reference.
Well, it is, a little bit.
Yeah.
But
let's hope it's not like the ending.
mildly disappointing. Yeah.
Mildly disappointing. Well, this isn't. Let's make that clear.
Absolutely not.
Absolutely not.
I mean, this is Kalavi. Am I pronouncing that correctly? Stain.
Kalavi Stain. Yeah.
So where have we had this from?
Right. Kalavi are Sarah and Gwynon, who are based in Bangor.
Right.
I saw them two or three years ago in Real.
Right.
On the bill with some of my friends and from White Teeth, the punk band, an industrial rock electro metal band.
Well, that's interesting because I wrote down it's like thrash metal meets EDM meets 80s pop.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All combined.
First thing, I know they did a cover of a Rammstein track a while back. So, but they also say that their influences include Combi Christ and the Birthday Massacre, who I'm afraid I haven't heard of before.
It's new to me as well. Yeah.
Yeah, but Nine Inch Nails and Rammstein are definitely up there with their sort of influences. But I also hear sort of shoegazy sort of when he goes into like the quiet bits and before they go into the thrash metal parts, which reminds me of sort of the singer from Saint Etienne, and also a band I used to like a few years ago called School of Seven Bells, very sort of shoegazy sort of act. So they go from really hard metal to very sort of soft shoegazy sort of sounds. I think.
Were you looking at your Hush Puppies during that, Phil?
Yeah, I was. I was thinking rather than a screamer sort of vocalist, they've got this lovely gentle girl's voice in there. I put it like a babyish girl's voice in there, which is makes it unusual.
Yeah,
you know. I thought it was a bit of Linkin Park as well about it, but also going back in time, New Model Army sort of vibes with the drumming and stuff.
Yeah, good show.
So,
on that.
So they've got some great influences there, and they've knitted it together to make it a unique sound. And, very relevant to the Only Human community.
I thought they were programmed drums, but no, he plays those drums. I was wondering what sort of kit they've got. And obviously there's some bass kit in there. But Sarah, she's also a presenter on Mon FM and also Soundwave Radio over in Colwyn Bay.
Right.
Again, she's played some of my stuff and some of our community. She's played the music, I think, Johnny Diamond.
Right.
So,
great, yeah.
So it's worth our community get in touch with her to play stuff on her radio station as well.
Oh, absolutely. And again, if we remember, we'll try and stick some links in below, which we won't do, but we'll just say we'll do it.
Yeah. I have to get on air for an interview.
Idea, Phil. This is the sort of interaction we need. These are the sort of genius ideas we should be popping out left, right and centre. This is why we're having you on here. Tell you what, Martin, have you got your cassette ready?
Yeah. I've got it.
Okay, pop it in. This is Kalavi. Oh. This is Stain.
It won't go in again.
Story of my life.
Wow, that was Calavi Stain. That is a very unique sound, and it's quite difficult to achieve a very unique sound for yourself these days, because a lot of stuff you can end up sounding like a bit like something else. And we do that quite often on the show and say, oh, well, that reminds me a bit of this. This really has got such a unique sound to it. There's elements of it you can pick out from something else, but as a whole, yeah, that's a very unique piece of, well, just a unique feel to the whole thing.
No, they're good to see live as well. So yeah, well, hopefully when we can all get back into seeing people live, and when they start doing some gigging around local venues, yeah, go and see them.
Yeah, so, and let's hope we can all get out watching gigs and gigging for ourselves soon as well. We've got a new feature coming up. This is very, very exciting. So let's play the jingle.
Technical talk in 10.
There might be a jingle there, there might not be. We'll find out when the show actually goes live.
I've got to shorten up once again.
But if there isn't a jingle, I'll just make one up on the spot. This is Tech Talk in 10. So this is our new feature, Tech Talk in 10. Martin's abbreviated it to TTI10. He keeps saying TTI10. I don't think he means to. It just keeps coming out that way, Martin, doesn't it?
It's just my accent.
I think it is. Yeah. So this is TTI10. So but the idea is that we'll have a Tech Talk in less than 10 minutes. It'll just be a very brief one. And each episode, we'll try and bring in a special guest who will talk us through a production technique and talk us through something that perhaps we don't know how to do. Now, because it's the three of us on and we haven't got a special guest this week, we've had to make up our own Tech Talk in 10 this week. So we've got coming up next as a song, we've got Azura, Radio Universe, I think it
that is
isn't it?
It's from the album Radio Universe. Ah. It's Lonely Star.
Okay, so it's track number 7, Lonely Star, Radio Universe. Okay, that makes more sense from what I've written down. So on this one now, there is an amazing piece of really thick sidechain compression on here. So we were going to just very briefly chat about it. Now, this is probably something everybody knows how to do. But if you don't, then we thought we'd just very quickly whiz over it and just explain what sidechain compression is. Does anybody want to stick their hand up and go first?
No.
No.
Right. I'll have a crack at it and then you can correct me. So usually use, well, particularly in EDM music, you'd usually have your bass line running and then you have your kick, which then actually runs as the compressor over your bass line. So what you do is you put your compressor on the bass line and then you run the bus from your kick through into the bass line so that you then punch through the bass line so that when your kick kicks in, your bass line drops out. And you'll hear that quite a lot in dance music. So you get that like pumping sound at the dance music, yeah, then where your kick drops in and your bass drops out. Is that right, Phil?
It's a ducking sound.
It's a ducking thing. So you have to remember to activate your side chain in your plug-in or whatever your real hardware, plug whatever your signal is into the side chain,
yeah,
and make sure it's activated, and then route your signal of your bass drum in your case. But another good one for a side chain is a gate, and say you can put a hi-hat pattern into the side chain on a gate that's running on a pad.
Right.
So instead of strings, so say you've got a straight strings and your hi-hat pattern, I'm going to do an impression here, goes, yeah, you put that through the side chain on your pad and your pad will go, instead of going, it'll go, that's how they get that EDM type of pulsating strings.
Right.
That's through the side chain as well.
And I think on this track, it's the pad that has been sidechained. I was trying to listen out for a bass or a kick they got sort of sound going on with this track.
But that is a great idea to use the gate. I'd never thought about that. Mm.
Yeah, to use the sidechain on the gate, and usually a hi-hat is the best one with a pad.
Right.
But Marty just said, I don't know whether they're using a compressor or a gate to make the swelling. It's usually a compressor, isn't it, Martin, for that type of pumping that they've got going on there?
It sounds like a pumping sort of sidechain effect. Now, I mean, I cheat most these days because to be honest, I forget how to do it. So there are plenty of plugins out there where you can just add a preset, and which basically does the whole thing without. So you put the add the preset onto your track, and it sidechains automatically.
Because you can use it for live performance as well. So like if you've got a lead guitar and you've got a singer. And sometimes the two are fighting a little bit because the lead guitar is quite loud and then your singer's trying to cut through that lead guitar. You can actually put your compressor on your guitar and then have the bus take through the lead singer's voice so that it actually drops the guitar down. So when the lead singer starts singing, and obviously you get your get the compression level right, but it'll just drop the guitar down a little bit when the lead singer is singing, so just to let them cut through the noise. Well, do you know what? I think we've made a fairly decent fist of that. That's not bad for a first TTI 10.
Yeah, and the thing is, it's to inspire anybody out there who's doing a bit of production to try these things out and see if they can get it to work at the end of the day. And if we get some decent guests on that put their name through to the email address that want to talk about certain things, that'd be good.
Absolutely.
Unlike presenters, you mean?
Yeah, exactly, Martin. So, and if you want to pop some through, so pop a song through if you want to come on and talk about production technique, whatever it is, it's onlyhumanradio@gmail.com. We'd be delighted to have you as a guest or delighted to play your music.
Damn thing keeps on speaking.
Well, it would do because I haven't named the song yet. So it's going to be Azura. This is Lonely Star from the album Radio Universe. Pop it in, Martin. Here we go. Now, that was a slick job.
Martin's monster. Monster. Monster.
It's gargantua, gantua, gantua, gantua.
It's not about money. It's truly about making the difference in the life of another human.
Only Human Radio.
That was Azura, Lonely Star. What a piece of music. And as you say, that pumping compression in there, that side chaining was amazing there. And we were just talking as we were saying in there, that was actually an 8-minute song. Didn't feel it at all. That just raced by.
It just goes quick, yeah.
Yeah, superb, absolutely superb piece of music. So, yeah, how did you find it, Phil?
Actually, I reminded me a bit of one of Martin's sort of type of tunes. Well put together, lots of build in, drop in, dynamics, lovely piano, like samples and synth. It got a really an epic sort of a quality to it.
I've been rumbled.
Did you have a hand in it?
No, but it's funny. I listened to it earlier again because I haven't listened to Azura for a while, and I thought, oh my god, it sounds so much like my previous album Dark Skies, which is all very spatial and space rock sort of music.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
I thought this is a bit too similar.
But a little fact, a little interesting Azura fact. Azura or Asura or whatever how they pronounce it, is a divine being in the, I think, Hindu religion.
Is it now?
Azura is a guy called Charles Fairway, or he's French, so maybe it's Charles, I should imagine he pronounce it.
Right, yeah.
But when I first started writing about 2009, this was, I started to listen to this sort of this type of music, and he's on a group of musicians called the Ultima record label. There's other acts like A.S. Dana, Carbon Based Life Forms, Solar Fields. I don't know if anyone knows any of these are, but it's artists. But I think he's done about 4 albums to date. Yeah, his music is I find so inspiring to me. And it is epic.
Yeah, is the word.
It really
was a major piece of music, that. Right, well, that was amazing. So thank you very much indeed for that. Now, coming up now, we've got an interview with a special guest that I did a little bit earlier. So this is an interview with Tim Lewin. And Tim is a musical inventor and a musician. And we've played some of Tim's stuff before. So we've played stuff that he made using Amstrad sounds. We've made stuff he's made using Commodore 64 sounds and Windows 7 sounds. Tim's been working on a 30-track album, and he's also been working on some inventions that he's been working on. Honestly, I could have talked to this guy for hours on end. It really is phenomenal. So let's just have a little chat with Tim Lewin, and then we'll come straight out of that, listen to one of his songs, and then we'll have a little chat. So here he is. This is our good friend Tim Lewin. Well, what a treat we've got in store now, because we've got someone extremely special who's joined us on the show. I'm just so appreciative of you coming to have a chat with us today, because you're one of the most interesting people that I've ever come across with everything that you've done creatively, and I've never had the chance to actually have a conversation with you. We're chatting tonight to Tim Lewin. He's the instrument inventor. Tim, how
Hello.
Are you?
Oh, fine. I've just been extremely busy working on lots of things at the moment, inventing things, as you do, in my bedroom full of keyboards. And that's what I've been doing at the moment. Just had chocolate biscuits right now.
Oh, chocolate biscuits. If I could only just reach through and just grab one of those.
Well, teleportation may happen at some point in the future.
You never know your luck. I tell you what, we're going to come on to your inventing in a minute. First thing I want to chat with you about is your album. So the album you've been creating for, it's been a little while you've been building on this, hasn't it?
Yes, it has. It has. It's been a painstaking long-term goal, I will admit.
So when you were thinking about doing it, because it's, and again, we'll try and describe this a little bit to people about what you've achieved or what you're in the process of achieving with this. So when you were thinking about doing this, what was your idea behind the whole concept?
Well, the whole concept was really to bring back that nostalgia with 8-bit sounds and old computers from the 1980s. Like, because really it all started from literally playing a game when I was a child.
Yeah.
And the game that I played was a classic game named Descent 3 or Descent 2. And what it is, it's basically a sprite flight shooter game. And the guys who made the game was fantastic. And that game inspired me to make my music for my album. And, you know, I wanted to do this because literally I've been looking around for chiptune type style music to do with the Commodore 64. And I couldn't find any actual albums based on the old computers. Most of the computers, most of the games was composed on the tape. So what people have done, they've recorded it back to tape. There isn't like an actual complete album made on the Commodore 64. And that's the reason why I've done it, you know.
So, but not the whole album's on the Commodore 64, is it? Because you've got like Windows, I think you've got a Windows 7 one, is it, in there? And then you've got an Amstrad one you've done in there. And
Well, they're separate tunes. They're just some music that, you know, I composed in my free time.
Yeah.
But the album was basically made using some software that there's an actual plugin company called VST4Free.com.
Right.
And what people do up there is listen to old software and program VSTs for us musicians to use.
Yeah.
And it's an open source platform. And there's a lo-fi section. And basically, I downloaded one of these plugins, this Commodore 64 emulation, which emulates the SID chip found in the Commodore 64. And basically, what I done, I started to program my own sounds, and I just fell in love with this plugin. And then I downloaded all the plugins from that website before they got glitchy and corrupted, and something happened to the plugins. They got deleted for some reason. So I went crazy and just went scouring the internet for all of these Commodore 64 emulation plugins for free.
And that's how you built everything. So have you, so which door do you use to pull all this together then?
I use one door, but I use all the packages. I use Mixcraft 6 Pro. That's what I use to, you know, mix it all and layer all the tracks together. Yeah. That's what I used. And all I've done is literally basically drag the VST, taken the DIL file, put it in the VST folder, and then just composed my sound from that. And saved like a sound bank inside the actual VST itself.
Right.
And then I just laid it all up together.
Because some of the songs you've created are just, I mean, they're just beautiful, really, some of them. They're like soundscapes, but in an unusual way that you'd never have conceptualized trying to make a piece of music that way, using that chiptune type of sound. But what you've created out of it, and that's why it's like an experience.
Yeah. Well, there's a story to my album, and basically it's about these people that live in this electronic circuit world.
Yeah.
And basically there's a guy that actually lives in this city, and through each track there's like a story to basically this kind of, how can I put it, electronic circuit futuristic world where this guy lives in, and he tells a story throughout every single track about how his day goes.
That's amazing. And when do you think you'll, I mean, when's the final track going to be done? When's the album actually going
to
be out?
Well, last Saturday I started to mix and work on my second half of my album. Yeah. I've already finished five tracks. I'm working five tracks every Saturday and Sunday.
Right.
Because Saturday and Sunday is my music day. Through the week is all like making projects and inventing things. So I'm working like five tracks every weekend, and it shouldn't take me too long, really. It's just the mixing has just been a nightmare because it's lo-fi sounds.
Yeah.
So to mix it is a lot different, is a lot harder than just normal sounds, if you know what I mean, because you're dealing with lo-fi 8-bit sounds.
Yeah.
So if you try to equalize it or change it or, you know, put effects on it, it can wreck the sounds, and it's very, very difficult to mix. So the mixing just takes so long to do.
Yeah, absolutely. And how many songs are going to be on the finished album?
30 tracks.
30 tracks. Now that is a treat.
30 tracks. And I've got 30 tracks of Game Station music. And I can actually tell you some of the actual names of the album.
Yeah,
some of the tracks if you want to hear them. So Floppy Drive Funk, that's the first track. Track 17, Solenoid Subway Travel. A Night at the Ram Restaurant.
he's a brilliant.
Corruption Core Control. And what I've tried to do with all the track names, you try to make it relative to like electronics, technology, old computers, video games. I try to make it related to my album.
That's amazing. That is absolutely amazing. Do you know what? I just cannot wait to listen to that. I genuinely can't. And I can't wait. We've played some tracks already on the radio show, but I just can't wait to find the whole thing and then play some more tracks. But before we start wrapping up, Tim, there's something else I want to talk to you about, because we did introduce you as Tim Lewin, the instrument inventor.
Yeah.
Now,
yeah,
it isn't just a small guitar or something like that you're inventing, is it? You're inventing something really genuinely unique and unusual, aren't you?
Yes,
more than
yes,
one thing actually. So let's talk about your special bottle organ first. Let's just do that one first.
Well, one, it's not a bottle organ. It's a mechanical xylophone.
Yeah.
And basically, the reason why I've made this is because me being a musician, I love exploring sounds. And basically, this all started literally from going in somebody's recycling bin and finding a Jack Daniels bottle and then just bringing it. And then from there, I just fell in love with the sound. So I spent months, and I mean months, designing this thing. And basically, what it is basically there's 30 keys in total for the whole instrument. And you use your tip of your fist to pull one of the keys. Each key is basically connected to a hammer, which hits the back of the bottle and makes the sound. And that's basically how it works. And each individual bottle is filled with different levels of liquid to get the full range of notes. So you got the 3 liters, and then you got the 35 and everything in between. And that's how I'm able to achieve the full note range of the instrument.
That is amazing. If somebody wants to see that instrument in action, is there anywhere they can actually see you playing that?
Well, what I plan to do is at some point is once it's done and I've finished it all, I'll be putting lots of videos and live streams on my Facebook page, which is called Jack Daniels Whiskey Bottle Organ Project. And I've got over 600 followers there.
Right.
So that's where I'll be putting all the live stream and videos of me playing it on there.
That's amazing. Well, please let us know when that is and we'll promote that as much as we possibly can. But we were talking just before we started recording and you were showing me as well your new invention, which is your tin can threaded bar chimes. Just take us through that again, Tim, because that is just astonishing.
So basically these tin can thread chimes, right? I discovered this just literally by basically just by putting a hole in the top of the can and putting a thread bar and tightening the top. And what's happening is as the bar is resonating, it's basically amplifying itself through the tin can, which is making the sound. So what I want to do is, because you can have up to 49 notes in this instrument, I want to make a modular kind of keyboard setup with like an octave in each. And use the tip of your fist, similar to my Jack Daniels thing. And you're basically playing tin can threaded bar chimes, but in a modular setup. And it makes it easier to transport, put away, you know. And that's basically what I'm trying to do as well. And I'll play a sound for you so you can hear it.
Yeah, please do. Yeah. That's amazing.
Yeah.
That with them all set up there. So how are you going to play it using little hammers like that then?
No, it's a mechanically operated instrument. So all those pictures I've sent you, right, of my instrument, it's all going to be using these piano hammers because I've got like boxes and boxes of these that are scrapped from old pianos.
Yeah.
And these are going to be at the back of the hammers and the keys are going to be kind of on top.
Yeah.
So when you pull one of the keys down, there's going to be a rope and pulley matrix, which then hits like that, and there's an octave in each individual module box spread across four octaves, so meaning that you can have three, two, you can have as many octaves as you like because it's modular, and it means that two people can play at the same time.
Right. That is utterly astonishing. Tim, can you make me one promise now? When you've completed both the Jack Daniels one and the Tin Can one, can we do another one of these where we do a live thing of you actually playing these instruments?
Yeah, for sure. I'm up for that. Yeah.
That would be utterly astonishing. It really would. Tim, it's been an inspiration. Go on, mate. Yeah.
What else I'll do, I'll even do a tutorial video on how to build one as well.
That would be amazing.
If people want to build one, I'll make a tutorial video of how to do it.
That would be astonishing. Tim, you're an inspiration. It's been an utter pleasure. It really has, talking to a genius of music creation like you are.
Yeah.
Can't wait for the album. Can't wait to see the instruments. And just can't wait to see what you come up with next. So it's Tim, Lewin, it's been an absolute pleasure.
Absolute pleasure to meet you too. And maybe sometime this week or in the next couple of months, we can actually have a coffee somewhere if you're up for that.
Wouldn't that be amazing? Absolutely. I would be 100% up for that, mate. Yeah, superb. Tim, thank you very much.
Only Human Radio.
Well, that was Tim Lewin's song Whiskey Jack Jazz, which was amazing. But what an interesting guy. And if you're watching on the video on YouTube rather than listening on the radio, then we put some pictures up of the instrument that he was describing that he's actually created. So if you want to actually see what that looks like, either jump onto Facebook and have a bit of a browse around our Only Human site, because he's put some videos on there of him playing stuff and also some images. But also have a look at the video on YouTube, because there are some images on there. But another great song from Tim again.
Oh, it's amazing how he puts these together. And this is true found sound stuff. This is what he's put it together.
Yeah.
I had a chat with him the other day as well. And his ideas, what he's got coming up is just, you know, I couldn't think about doing this in a lifetime, I don't think.
Yeah, it is amazing. And he said he's got 60 ideas for different instruments, which is astonishing.
Yeah.
And again, you know, trying to put out a 30 track album, that's I wouldn't be able to put a 3-track album out at the moment,
I think he wants to put some form of once he's actually creating all this this equipment, he wants to put some sort of exhibition together, and I really hope he can do this, because if we can get it supported, I think he lives in Llandudno. If it can come about, it'd be fantastic. You know, to show these instruments off, that this is fairly unique. What he's doing.
It would be amazing, wouldn't it, Phil?
Yeah, it's. I think they're like a work of art, aren't they?
Yeah,
really.
Exactly that.
He sent me some pictures. It's like they're like CAD drawings he's sending me. So you know. And when I did a Zoom with him the other day, he's got some old keyboards. He's good with a soldering iron, I think.
Yeah.
With electronics, I think it's and he's only 25.
Yeah, it's amazing. It really is. How did you find the song as well, Phil?
Yeah. Well, I've written down here. I mean, he understands what I'm getting at here, because it's all positive. But it's like. I found it is this particular tune, because a lot of the other tunes have been very chip tune-ish.
Yeah,
using the old computer sounds and what have you. Very, it's got a very unique take on things. But this time, I felt like it was like a dreadlock holiday of bottle popping heaven.
Yeah,
like a whack-a-mole melody born of nostalgia, but blue sky thinking.
But very organic this time.
Yes. I could imagine those bottle tops being dunk, 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 dunk. It was and it got a bit of a reggae, sunshiny feel. It was a bit of a departure for his sound, for what I've heard before.
Yeah.
But no less creative. Just his got a unique way of thinking. Yeah, familiar. It's a familiar sort of feel to it.
And very well produced. And the clarity was superb.
Yeah, absolutely. And Tim has said that once he's completed his latest instrument, he will do a little live session for us as well, so we can actually see him doing it, and it'll be amazing. Can you imagine that? It's going to be phenomenal. It really is. So thank you very much, Tim Lewin, for that, for the interview and for the song, which were both absolutely amazing. We've got an Only Human stalwart coming up. He's an Only Human hero. It's Platform Zero.
Well, friend of the show, mate.
Friend of the show, mate. Absolutely. Yes. It is Platform Zero, our good friend David Hughes.
Yeah. Do you think he's got the best cat out of anybody in the community? The nicest cat.
It does seem lovely to be a nice one. I could run into a full carry-on scenario now.
Cat, I said.
Or are you being served?
Yeah, this is slow. This
is slow coming.
Never, it went over my head for years, that did. But anyway, come on.
Cats and synths, you know, it's a classic.
Yeah. There is a classic. Cat synth, and it's a classic, yeah.
Well, there you are, you see. It's all worked out for the best, isn't it? But Platforms, yeah. So David Hughes, it is another great David Hughes classic, Darwin Among the Machines. And David's amazing with his... He is a bit of an ARP king, isn't he? He knows how to run his ARPs.
This was top-notch, yeah. Yeah, Human League, Vince Clark feel to me. Nice drones, ambiences. Also, yeah, also to me, and sort of part of it, just reminiscent of my one of my old favourites is Tomita from the late '70s.
Yeah, it's a great piece of music. How do you find it, Phil?
Yeah, I thought it was. What I like about his stuff is he's got a thread. He's chosen his sounds.
Yeah.
And he tends to stick to them. And he's chosen some really good sounds. And a lot of the tracks I've heard, there's very similar pads. And what it's done is it's given him a unique signature, sonic signature. But it's always, you know, got a really sort of... I find it quite an emotional... I've said this before about it. It's emotional music, even though it's very synthetic.
Yeah.
I always get a feeling of emotion out of it. I think he's achieved something really good.
Yeah, he does tend to, but he makes very emotive pieces, doesn't he? And I don't know how he does it or what it is that's in there that kind of brings that emotion out. But there's something, a little hook in there somewhere, which, and another, it's just the feeling that he puts into it himself and whether there's a bit of himself. It'd be interesting to get him on and just ask him that question. How does he do it? He probably just speak him or something like that.
Yeah, yeah.
But it is an amazing piece of music. I tell you what, Martin, have you got your cassette ready? Does it get that bit of tape out from there? We've been using those TDK 120s again. Let's get this one plopped in there. So this is Platform Zero. This is Darwin Among the Machines. We'll be right back. Well, it was David Hughes, Platform Zero. He is an only human hero, as you quite rightly put in the song at Christmas, Phil.
Yeah, I singled a few out. The Sword Swinger as well.
Yeah.
I like a bit of a Sword Swinger.
I think I had a very brief mention at the beginning. Was Martin in there? Did he get left out? I can't remember.
I
feel bad that I brought it up.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think you gave one of my tracks an honourable mention, which was very nice.
Oh, oh, that's good. Are. Yeah, I hope so. I feel bad else now.
I won't hold it against you much.
Cheers, man.
Well, I tell you what, I've been enjoying tonight, and I've been enjoying tonight so much that we've actually got to the last song. Can you believe that? That's gone very quickly. Yep, way.
Yeah.
Yep. So, but what a belter. So, Martin, you've been in charge of the lineup tonight, and you've bookended this very, very nicely. But just before we introduce this one, Martin, because we've missed out a feature halfway through here, but, you know, we'll just make a point of it at the end. That maybe people ought to guess, because we had a new feature now, which was Martin's Monster. There was Martin's Monster track, and we forgot to mention it.
Oh, yes.
which one was that?
That was a zero, wasn't it?
Was it a zero?
That was the monster.
Okay, well, we'll just stick a jingle in here. Now it's time for a zero, Martin's Monster. Just rewind back about 7 or 8 minutes, something like that, and then press fast forward and get back to this next bit, or something like that. It'll be fine, I'm quite sure. So moving on from that, we do have our last song, which is...
Ray Spark Industries, you know, Drone Mix.
Paul Darlington.
Right, and what a song it is, isn't it, Phil? I mean, this is a proper, good, thick, heavy 90s soundtrack sort of stuff.
Yeah, it's got like great, to me, modular sounding rhythms, as if the drums and that were done on a modular system and with noise and proper organic sort of analog sounds. If he's done it via other means in a door or something, then he's done a really good job of recreating that that sort of thing. Does he use hardware?
I don't know, but so that there's a wonderful sequence part in there which is filtered. You know, that either he's automated or he's actually doing it in real time, filtering some of that sequencer. But that's fantastic.
And he's got a 303 in there that absolutely belts it out.
Yes, I've got that. Great emergence of the 303. Everybody, I'll tell you what, everybody in this group never overdoes the 303. It's just, it's always tasteful, isn't it? In the only human community or people that submit stuff, they never over in your face do the 303. It's always tastefully done.
It is like a very tasteful strip tease. It's just, yes. It's just there to enjoy.
Yes, nothing vulgar about it.
No, exactly. Exactly that. Now, Martin, you were just showing us your new piece of equipment earlier on. To keep the vulgar theme going, which is a Behringer TD3, which is a 303.
It is a 303, apparently. Yes, yeah. I'm a bit of a baby when it comes to the hardware. I'm still very software based. So I'm hoping I'm going to plug it into all the Volkers I've got and see what I can do with it.
Well, have you got it there? Just stick it up with the camera. So if anybody who's obviously on radio, this isn't really much good to anybody. So
yeah,
that's nice.
For radio.
That's nice. So that's a Behringer TD3. That's nice. Phil, do you want to just delve around in your box of goodies and just show us what you showed us earlier on?
Oh, yeah.
Come on, Phil.
It's a rare as hen's teeth Yamaha DX200.
Look at that.
By the Chemical Brothers.
Look at that. Pristine condition.
I sold the AN200. The guy came in and saw this and offered me twice as much as he paid for the last thing.
I would never sell that, no.
I love it. It's a bit of hardware I ever use.
It's an amazing piece of kit. And it's beautiful condition, everything. That really is. And we could perhaps have a special feature each week where we just hold up a piece of equipment, which is perfect for the radio listeners.
But just going back to Martin's bit of equipment, the great thing with that Behringer is it's like hardware for the price of a plug-in.
Oh, Christ, yeah. How much do you pay for that, Martin, if you don't mind me asking?
Just over 50 quid.
50 quid.
less than a lot of plugins.
50 quid.
Right, yeah.
Brilliant.
That is ridiculous. And if you read the reviews on that Behringer TD3, the reviews are fantastic on it. And it's saying, you know, for things that are £300 or £400, it's just as good, if not better.
Well, yeah. I want to get the Behringer version of the 606 next to get the... get the drum machine next.
That's better. That's better than the original 606 because I used to have one. It was awful.
Yeah,
the Behringer one is much better with the distortion and everything on it. Yeah.
Well, I tell you what, we can chat like a load of old ladies drinking our cup of tea over this song then. Yeah. So let's do that whilst we're enjoying Race Park Industries, you know, Droom Remix.
We'll be right back. numbing medication. 1, 2, 3.
Only Human Radio.
That was Race Park Industries, you know, Drone Remix. God, that was a cracking way to end the show. That was a proper dance beat, that.
Fabulous. Yeah.
Everything by Ray, but Race Park Industries is fabulous, though, isn't it? And again, yeah. And I know we've got our special little production feature that we've got, that we're going to be featuring from now on, but I've got to say the production on the songs tonight has been astonishing. Really has. The production levels are just right up there.
New Arcades, Calabi, our friend Tim, marvellous production from Tim.
Yeah.
Ross, Torsk, Azura, Kraken, Platform Zero, and Ray Spark. Yeah, brilliant.
There we go. I was going to do the rundown. I think you've covered them all. Have you covered them all?
I think I did, didn't I?
I think you did. That's fine. We don't need to do that.
Sorry about that.
It's a job saved.
Yeah, marvellous.
This is it. These are efficiencies that we're building in to the show, you see. Yeah. This is all good. This is all good stuff. So, gentlemen, it's been an utter pleasure chatting to you tonight. Next time round, hopefully we'll have some other guests on for us. So we've got our, so if anybody wants to join us, we would love to have somebody to talk about our TTI 10. It's TTI 10, Martin, not TTI 10. Okay.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, so join us on Tech Talk in 10. It would be great if somebody wants to pop on for that. I know we've had a couple of people already say yes, they'd like to do something. So you'd be more than welcome to come on. If somebody wants to do an interview about anything they're doing, so whether it's an album, whether it's a piece of musical equipment they want to talk about, whether it's something they're inventing like Tim Lewin was, whatever it is, again, we would love to have a chat with you. Wouldn't we, Phil?
Absolutely, yeah.
See, look at the excitement on Phil's face.
It's a community of love, isn't it? The only human community.
It is. It's exactly what it is.
And our closely associated friends as well.
Indeed. Yeah. And again, please, anybody out there, join our community. Just go on a Facebook search out for Only Human. You'll be more than welcome to join the community. It's a closed group. Just click and say you'd like to join us and we'll let you in straight away. If you want to send the song through, it's onlyhumanradio@gmail.com. We'll pick that up and we'll play that on the show. If you send a song through, we will play it. And again, we've been talking about high levels of production tonight, but it doesn't matter if you're new at doing this or anything. Just send your song through. We would love to play it. Look at that. Martin's got his finger in the air. Something's about to happen.
What was that email again, Jules?
Thanks, Martin. It was onlyhumanradio@gmail.com. Look at that. It's so slick, this show, isn't it? It's amazing. There we go. Who's going to do the big goodbye? I tell you what, we'll start off. Martin, you do a big goodbye first.
Goodbye.
It was very good. Phil?
In honour of Andy Peggs, goodbye.
So that's what I was waiting for. It wasn't quite as good as one of Andy's, but it was nearly there. We miss you, Andy.
I need to improve on that.
Yeah, well, to be honest with you, Martin, we have a word with you about that and your cassette insertion later on. But anyway, there we go. Thanks for joining us. I hope you've enjoyed the show too. We'll be back in a couple of weeks' time. Ta-da for now, and stay safe.
Ta-ra a bit.
Bye.
Ta-da.